Carnival, you might see our houses. All of them have families that live inside of them. On average, we have at least 5 people in the house here in our community. Sometimes it could be even more, because every now and then we might have one of our aunties that might come down and stay with us, or cousins, or somebody else who's next of kin. And we'll simply just allow them to stay with us because, you know, first of all, we love them.
Right.
And then second of all, we want them to have the same opportunity that we have. Which is to be able to come into the capital city.
We got free Wi-Fi at this park, so let's probably wipe people out.
Find a nice local job.
Yeah.
So we can take care of our families and the bills we might already have.
Now, what's the most traditional job here most people go after? Is it just having their own business, or just whatever they can find?
But things have changed traditionally over the years. Ever since recession. First of all, tourism is our number one industry.
Okay.
So you all helped to bring in at least 65% of the country's total revenue.
Okay.
Which is really already more than half of the total income we get in the entire country.
Mm-hmm.
The rest of the money comes from banking and then agriculture and fisheries. But the second largest amount of money coming into the country is from banking and mostly offshore banks. Where some people around the world, some say they hide their money, some say they just stash their monies in some of our offshore banks. Ever since the recession started and then now the pandemic, many people have been losing jobs, not really finding jobs. So the ones that's been most easily to find are simple jobs like gas station work, being a pump attendant at a gas station. They've been hiring people all day, every day, from the beginning of the pandemic, because you need them to fill people's gas, their cars up with gas.
So there's not a lot of people, so the looking for jobs, the market is in high for jobs right now. Like in our state, they're begging people to work. People don't want to work where we're from.
But that's only because they're getting that stimulus check.
Right, so it's not like that here.
No, most people, when the pandemic first started, they were giving a lot of people like $200 a week, then they took it down to $150 a week, then they took it down to $100 a week. So now people are collecting from the government, and that'll end in November, which is next month.
Oh, wow.
$100 every 2 weeks. Well, $200 every 2 weeks, which is $100 a week. And that's going to end next month. But there's still a lot of people who have been unemployed due to the fact that their company was out of work for like 6+ months. Some of them completely shut down because they simply couldn't afford to open back up. Hotels are still only at maybe 30, maybe 40% or less. So that means all the people that was working in those buildings are not working yet. So you can't pay people that you don't really need, or you wouldn't pay people that you don't really need. Been just using their own skills to make ends meet for themselves and their families. If you don't have a skill, you won't be in a rough position.
Wow.
So there's people like carpenters, car body repairmen, tailors, electricians. Some of the ladies do their own hair braiding. Some people sell the fruits that come off of their trees. People like this house right here, they sell breakfast in the morning.
Oh, wow.
A lot of people come and they would line up to buy the breakfast because it's good. A lot of men are barbers, cut hair on their front porches. People that aren't into none of those things, they would buy stuff and sell them.
Yeah.
Like buy cases of water and hang on the street corners and sell them for a dollar.
Yeah.
So it's like anywhere else where it's been affected by something that's hit your economy. Especially a place like us where tourism is the number one industry, but there's not much tourists coming.
Yeah.
Like those countries. Get in where you fit in.
Wow.
You be strong and you take care of your kids the best way you can.
why you see if some of them come there, they come to Alabama. Sit outside of Montgomery, the outskirts, Prattville, Millbrook, or something. One of these houses, they probably could buy for like $30,000. Yes. Some cheap than that. If you got the cash money, you probably get some from $5,000 to $10,000.
Only thing is, in the country, I think once you're done paying the mortgage, you own it. I don't know if you still have to pay a yearly tax. Uh-huh. I think anything under $100,000, you don't have to pay a yearly tax. Anything over, I think you do now. I can't remember the percentage that you pay, but oh, there's a percentage at least.
Shades, how they change color. Where can we go across the clear water? Nice Sunday on the beach. Wow.
Sandals Island all the way over there. Sandals Resort is in Cable Beach.
Oh,
west of you and continue going further west. But Sandals is an all couples resort, meaning that you can only go there if your honey comes with you. So once you go there together, they take you across the water to that private island so y'all can spend some personal time with each other, have some fun, you know, do some stuff. It's supposed to be nice and fun for all of the couples.
Have you been to Sandals?
No.
You never been to Sandals?
No. Not even once, darling. Only drove past it. I had to pick up one or two of my friends from work. That was it. There's a lot of places Bahamians don't really get to do, even in the country. We are so, like how a lot of our guests come to the Bahamas.
Uh-huh.
A lot of our Bahamian people like to go to the States.
Yeah.
For some reason, that's our preference when it comes to vacation, but we like to go where we want to go. Now, for the most part, the only difference in between what we call upper class and middle class is really, a lot of it is location. Even though some of the homes are going to look a little bit bigger, a little bit more beautiful, for the most part, the further you get closer to the ocean, the more expensive your house is going to be. A lot of these are big and beautiful, but for the most part, they're mostly really expensive because they are right by the border. $1,000 and up.
Good, great.
You'll find lawyers, doctors, bankers, politicians, some private school teachers, plus some other folks who have found themselves financially better off, whether they've been making their monies legally or illegally. You'll find a good number of them living right here in some of our same communities. As time went on, a lot of the housing also built with cement block or cinder block. So for say like last 40 years or so, we've really only been using cement block or cinder block, which is of course the ideal material for the tropical storms and hurricanes that travel to our islands on a yearly basis.
Big family.
Well, before we had a lot of open yards.
Yeah.
People really didn't feel like they had the need to really put fencing or walls around the yard. Because there was really a lot of peace. Not much people trying to find opportunities to get in your yard to take from you. But the 90s came around and things got different. So that's where a lot of these construction people and house manufacturing people got an opportunity to make more money.
So like these guys that's doing paint and construction, do they make pretty good money?
Well, a lot of them do, because you won't work for someone that's not going to pay you what you're asking them to pay you for, whatever they need you to do. And so they make some money.
I guess it's a lot of word of mouth, huh?
Well, it is, but you know. Can be an average construction worker making about maybe $9 or $10 an hour depending on your skill, and you might be able to make some good money, or some will say average construction worker kind of money, or you can end up knowing somebody in the government. Your cousin might be the Minister of Works or the Minister of Housing. Because he has so many contracts under his portfolio, and you being his family member, he might be able to give you a contract worth about maybe $200,000 to build up a certain area on the island. pay you to boss, you hire.
Truck drivers. What are truck drivers? Are there any here?
Yeah, we got two. They will be working in different parts of the island where there's major construction.
Okay.
But they towed a lot of dirt in different places. Mm-hmm. They help build up buildings like what you see.
So they make pretty good money?
Yeah, that's good money automatically, yeah. It is. Automatic when you are a truck driver, you make your money, I think, by the hour. Have your own truck, you can determine exactly if you want to settle for the payment or not. But anytime you see, when it comes to hand-on work like construction, welding, they'll always make their money. Now, if they're hired by a Bahamian company, you won't always get what you deserve. For some reason, when companies here hire Bahamian companies, the owners of those companies like to keep the majority of the money,
yeah,
and pay you as a worker just what they want to pay you.
Yeah.
Now,
contracted out.
Right. Now we could have contractors come from the U.S. and they could say, well, we want to do a project. We want to build something up for your country. They won't be able to do that without a Bahamian.
Okay.
Mm.
So a Bahamian will have to be someone they would have to talk to who already has a degree in that field, who's already a professional in that field. And they'll say, okay, well, I'm willing to pay you this amount because the project I want to build here, it'll take maybe 2 years. And then they'll go in their little meetings with whoever they trust. And they'll be telling you, if the person said to them, to give you about $10 million for a 2 or 3 year project.
Uh-huh.
They'll come and they'll turn. They might not. You're just a worker, so they wouldn't tell you anything.
Right.
But the people that they want to oversee the project, they'll tell them, okay, this project is worth about $500,000,
mm-hmm,
and keep the rest of the money. Hello.
So when does school let out again?
Well, it's supposed to close around May. And then be out in the summer, June, July, August, go back in September for the fall. Be in their semester, September, October, November. And have like midway through December, winter break. Come back in the new year after Christmas and start a winter semester.
So it's kind of sort of like I saw. If they close in May, but they come back in June to do their prom?
It might close in May, but remember, prom is only for the ones that's leaving school.
Oh, okay, so that's when they come back.
That wouldn't affect them having their prom.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, we still have our prom while school is in, like the last month or so before school is out. That's part of their senior activities. There you go.
Twin brothers and young girl now.
Yeah. One of the very famous restaurants in the
history. Yeah, Chocano Beach.
This is the beach I normally stop to for my guests on a regular basis. After we do a tour, I normally go there to find fresh fried foods, fried fish, fried chicken, shrimp, lobster, pound.
And what's her name? Miss Sonia?
Well, Lady Sonia.
Lady Sonia.
Sonia's Jerk is an outdoor restaurant where Lady Sonia, she specializes in mostly stuff on the grill. Jerk ribs, barbecue ribs, jerk chicken, jerk pork. She likes to do stuff because she's Jamaican by nature. She likes to do stuff like oxtails, curry chicken, white rice. She loves cooked food and stuff like that too. That love you. Enjoy and licking your faces, rubbing your tummy. And then there's also right next to her Butters. Butters is more popular for like fried foods, fried chicken, fried fish. So that's why they can coexist from one side of one another. They do two different kind of menus.
Okay.
So I always stop there because you're in between two nice different cultures. All at the same time while you want a nice meal. Thank you.
So the prom was right around this corner.
Yeah, in front of the Hilton Hotel.
Yep.
That's where they go. This is one of the hotels that would help host them.
Okay. I get it, man. Cookie cutter. See, Kendra can come pick us up and go take us to some spots, show us what's really popping on the island.
Yeah, hopefully things will get better as time goes on.
Yeah.
We're hoping for the most part. Don't mind them changing, but we want it to get better.
Yeah.
Anytime it takes you back while your expenses are going up, that's not a good thing.
Yeah.
That's why I want to develop this website and quickly get it very popular.
Right.
So that I can continue to give a lovely guest like yourself a nice experience. You know, and have them wanting to keep coming back for a local experience. But before you know it, if you don't get it there, people will come here and they will only believe that the Bahamas is only commercialized.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of people won't come back for what's not originality.
Mm-hmm.
They'll come once and still miss out on the whole island. Stuff locally every day, having fun, introducing them to our real culture, doing what we do, having them be able to come and see us in our areas, doing what we do on a nice, professional, beautiful level. You know, give them reasons to say, you know what, we love the way they beautifully black, let's go and support them. But if,
yeah.
But if people keep coming and they only see like a bunch of foreignized places, and they only run into a lot of white-owned companies.
Yes.
Some people will want to go to Cuba and go back to Jamaica because they never change.
Mm-hmm.
You can go to Jamaica right now, you're still running into a bunch of local people. And they're talking like the way they were turned on. And why does they realize it's real?
I think they get tired of us, though.
Well, of course, no doubt.
Yeah,
they still have no time. Well, I mean, okay, take me for example. I'm a local that's been doing this now about 11 years.
Mm-hmm.
I always say you got some people that work on jobs just because it pays them.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have some people that literally love what they do.
Yeah.
I grew up around people singing songs to guests for 25 cent pieces and
mm-hmm.
selling flutes for $1 and walking up to guests and having an experience that you could get with nobody else because all of you are different from one another. So
right.
Talking, you're interacting, plus you're learning all at the same time about more than just one culture.
Yeah.
You're learning about two because you're educating them on yours, but they're also educating you on theirs. And then you know you wouldn't ever see these people unless they came through international waters. So,
yeah, true.
I don't think it's something whereby I think people just take it for granted over a period of time.
Yeah.
And so you could get used to it. But if you love what you do, you don't really never get tired.
Okay.
The only reason why, me personally, like I would walk away from the industry, not that I can't thrive in it, because it's our own people doing a lot of the pushback. It's not even the people that come to visit us saying they don't want to come.
Yeah.
It's our own people saying we don't want y'all to be there because y'all are making too much money.
Okay.
We don't want y'all to get beyond the average.
Mm-hmm.
Want y'all to stay in that black hole that y'all in.
Yeah.
when people call for you all, then we will call you all one at a time. Yeah. I don't like to be around that mindset and environment. Because what it says to me is, we're following a trend we've been following for years, which is just keep people down while the world is basically growing in different parts and different sections. And it's just a bad place that's in your mind when you think about it. It's unfortunate. Because you're watching all of these different companies blossom. Everyone is growing as far as the major companies. Mm-hmm. Why can't we have our own companies also grow?
Mm-hmm.
Why can't we have our own local people also become millionaires?
Yeah.
Or also be so beneficial that people will say, you know what? That person also deserves to be recognized as somebody big, somebody important, you know, because of what they do.
Mm-hmm.
But It's like the more you come out there as an individual, just trying to be a positive impact on people, the more they look at you in a criminal mindset. I honestly don't like that, because you are targeted before you get an opportunity to even be somebody nice.
Yes.
Be somebody worth something. It's almost like, even though the guests are nervous, you make them second guess us before they even get to know us.
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
But it was so nice meeting you, kid.